start on page 406.
407.
407.
Us children central to the Syriac liturgy. The notion of the incense and the busolio is central to everything we do, in the office in the morning, in the office in the evening. And so this rite of conversion is what it actually is. We have to make sure that the incense actually works and the charcoal is not lighting. And hearing confessions, I can't believe it, and before the mass begins. So I apologize for this tardiness.
Glory and thanks to you, to the Father, to your only begotten Son. Hallelujah, Hallelujah.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. John, proclaiming life to the world. Let us listen to the proclamation of life and salvation to our souls.
Remain silent, O listeners, for the Holy Gospel is about to be proclaimed to you. Listen and give glory and thanks to the Word of the living God.
The Lord Jesus says, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, he will give you another advocate, Paraclete, to be with you always, the Spirit of truth, which the world cannot receive, because it neither sees nor knows it. But you know him, because he remains with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you, and in a little while the world will no longer see me. But you will see me, because I live, and you will live. On that day, you will realize that I am in my Father, that you are in me, and I in you. This is the truth. Peace be with you. This is a called the Ten Commandments, but it's not just what we call that. It's the Decalogue, or literally the Ten Words. And around them, of course, is the whole doctrine, Torah. And this is what Moses brings down to them. So Pentecost, at the time of our Lord, this 50th day of Passover, commemorated this event on Mount Sinai, the giving of the law. This is why there are so many people in Jerusalem. This is the second most important holiday in the year, both for the Jews and for the Christians, this giving of the law. Now, on the Ascension, the apostles were told to go back to Jerusalem to pray, to wait for the promise of the Father. We know it took 9 days. We know the events of the place of Pentecost. They didn't. They were simply praying, as we're told by St. Luke, with the Mother of God in the midst of them. They prayed with the Blessed Virgin during these days. But it's during the great festival in the morning, as we're told at 9 a.m., we have this house which is filled with the sound of this wind. So to the people in the street, around, it sounds as if this house is exploding or going to blow up. And this causes them to stop immediately and figure out what is going on in this house. It's the reason why we have all these different peoples who are here. The Cyrenaeans, Libyans, Pamphylia, people from Pontus, people from Mesopotamia. They are all there because they are pilgrims who have come for the celebration commemorating the giving of the law. And in the midst of that, God works this new wonder, this new miracle. And in this rushing sound of the winds that surround and penetrate this world, we are told that fire appears over each of the individuals in this upper room and settles on them. So we imagine these little flames everywhere. Now we know this story. We don't necessarily remind ourselves or think of the fact that this is the most important day of the year after the glorious resurrection. They are intimately linked together. Because on Mount Sinai, what God does is he gives the law externally on a mountain that is consumed by fire and lightning and thunder in order to form a people, Israel. Whereas what takes place in Pentecost is a reuniting, not a separation of a people out from others, but a sacramental history which is meant to bring all of the races and the nations back into the singular unity which was meant to have been in what's created in Adam and Eve in the garden. And so the fathers, as they make the parallel between the old Adam and the new Adam, the Adam of paradise and the new Adam of Calvary, his resurrection, they also make the aspect of which from the side of Adam was created, woman, is created his spouse. And so as Eve is created from Adam, so on Calvary in the death of our Lord, the mystical spouse, the church, is created from the side of our Lord. But that spouse comes into her matrimonial procession, if you like, her manifestation, her moment of glory on Pentecost. This is the epiphany of the church. Whereas the disciples, the apostles, have been around our Lord over these last years, it is now the church which becomes her appearance, which is not only spouse of our Lord, the new Eve, but is also our Lord's body itself, the two in one flesh. And so it is the great importance of this day. What I want to leave you with is to understand that what was actually something that divided the race by forming Israel, it was all external to the people who stood there at the mountain and, as it were, wet their pants in terror in front of this epiphany. And it's all external to them. They see beyond themselves. It forms them by teaching them, but it doesn't transform them individually. What takes place on that day of Pentecost in the upper room on Mount Zion in Jerusalem, the fire is not external to them. Fire is upon each of the disciples who are present. Because on one hand, we have the writing of the law by the finger of God on stone tablets. Yes, it is. This is the writing of the law of God upon the hearts of men, flesh, in shown in the way that we act, in the way that we carry ourselves in our life of virtue. This is what St. Paul means when he writes to us in his letters by saying that you must become the children of the remnant of Christ. You must become Ezra, the Meshimo. You must become the fragrance of the Messiah. That fragrance of the Messiah is the way that we live, the way that we dress, the way that we speak, the life of virtue that we radiate out of. So that's its whole meaning. But again, we'll do a sermon on the soil at some other point. For us on Pentecost, this aspect of the fire, the light, the wind, is to remind us that our lives are to be fundamentally and profoundly transformed by grace. It's insufficient if we're just a little bit better than our pagan neighbor. Because our example and our role is not to imitate our neighbor, but to imitate Christ himself, God incarnate. And so on this day, we ask that light, the light be shed upon us, that fire consume us. And before the communion ceremony, we will do the adoration ceremony of the We have 35 copies of it printed out at the ends of these pews. You can snag them somewhere between now and the time before communion. And then an explanation of that ceremony will go up to the street, because I can't do three sermons on one occasion, otherwise we need to wait too long. And I already got the leadership together. So we ask for this fire and transformation of us interiorly from the law of Christ, which is written upon each of our hearts. In doing so, we ask for this profound conversion, which is an ongoing, lifelong thing. I want to leave you with a quotation from St. Catherine of Siena. She says, "Thou art the fire always burning, but never consuming. Our Lord is fire, is infinite fire. But thou art the fire always burning, but never consuming. Thou art the fire, consuming in thy heat all the soul's selfish love." We have this thought reflected in the morning prayers in the Maronite office. The light of the Spirit of God that is given to us burn away all our selfishness like dross, purify the whole. But thou art a fire consuming in thy heat all the soul's selfish love. Thou art a fire, lifting all chill and giving light. It's a very beautiful image of the grace that we are seeking today, that God may purge us of our selfishness, turn us ever towards the invitation of the Messiah, and in doing so, that we shall see him become that good fragrance, that perfume of Christ in the world and in this generation that God has given us to live. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you.
the seat of the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We confess on baptism and forgiveness of sins, and we look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Of the
Thank you.
the sins we have committed with or without knowledge.
Grant us pardon, O God, and forgive us in departing, that your blessed name be glorified in us and in all things. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and of your living Holy Spirit, now and forever.
As it was, is now, and shall be forever.
And with your spirit, let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility.
day when heaven rejoiced and earth was glad. The cherubim sang, the seraphim cried out, and the apostles exulted, having received the Holy Spirit of charity. On this day, the divine function taken away from Adam, our father, because of his disobedience, was restored to us. With it, the disciples were anointed, people were forgiven, and all nations were granted salvation. O Lord our God, to you be glory now and forever.
Amen.
Let us now kneel before the Lord upon both knees.
Let us kneel and ask the Lord for mercy. Bow your heads and worship God with the Holy Spirit, who spoke to the prophets, made himself understood through interpreters and visionaries, revealed hidden things and announced things to come. He descended upon the apostles in the likeness of the tongues of fire.
O Holy Spirit of the earth, please may we become your temples of your glory to serve you. For you perfect and sanctify our souls with your grace. We worship you, O Holy Spirit, and the Father and the Son, now and forever.
Amen.
By the power of God, stand up. Lift up your heads and bless yourselves with the cross of light, placing your souls the assistance, salvation that came from the Holy Spirit, whom you have worshipped in faith with the Father and the Son, now and forever. Back from error,
Grant protection to the living and best of hope, to the prayers of the Virgin Mary and all the saints.
Father,